A tentative deal is struck by U.S. dock workers and employees to suspend this week's strike till next year. The ILA union declared its historic protest action over for now, as it accepted a 61% wage hike for a six-year contract Thursday. Longshore employers increased the offer after pressure from the Biden administration for a contract with higher pay. President Joe Biden hailed the agreement that he said would reopen ports and ensure critical supplies reach areas affected by Hurricane Helene. The two sides will hold negotiations until January 15, which is expected to cover unresolved issues, including advanced automation that workers fear could lose them their jobs. We continue our monitoring of world oil prices as tensions continue to grip the Middle East. U.S. President Joe Biden confirms Washington is holding talks to strike on Iran's oil facilities as retaliation for Tehran's missile attack on Israel. Biden, however, says he does not believe there will be an all-out war in the oil-rich Middle East, but admitted that more needs to be done to ensure that. Global oil benchmarks, however, are both down but near the flat line, despite the worsening conflict. Here at home, fuel prices are headed higher, also due to the heightened tensions in the Middle East. A liter of diesel could be more expensive by 70 centavos next week. Prices of kerosene seem to increase between 15 and 35 centavos. As for gasoline, it is expected to go down by 50 to 70 centavos per liter. Philippine President Marcos Jr. set to advance the country's key interests at the back-to-back Association of Southeast Asian Nations Summit and related summits. The Foreign Affairs Department says Marcos will attend over a dozen engagements in Vientiane in the Lao People's Democratic Republic from October 8 to 11. He is expected to discuss boosting the digital economy, supporting MSMEs, and developing renewable energy with some of the region's top leaders.
There are also possible bilateral meetings between the president and the other heads of state at the sidelines of the meetings. So far, the ones being confirmed are the ones with Canada, New Zealand, Vietnam, and Japan.
DFA Assistant Secretary Daniela Espiritu also says Marcos will likely reassert the country's sovereignty over the West Philippine Sea. While he did not expound, Espiritu notes the president's stand on the country's jurisdiction has always been in accordance with international law.
The president always champions that issue, in all of the summits from the very start. The ASEAN member states have always been committed to the peaceful settlement of disputes in the South China Sea, especially within the ambit of UNCLOS.
Corporate stories now at the local front. Jaime Alfonso Zabel de Ayala is joining a key investment council of the Trade Department. The heir to the Ayala Group will sit in the council for 3 years as private sector representative for Metro Manila. The interagency body seeks to streamline efforts to draw more foreign investments to the Philippines. As for Repower Energy Development Corporation, it secured the government contract for a wind energy farm in Quezon Province. The company says the Energy Department approved its application for the wind service energy contract of the Pandan-Labayat project.